All right, I got 5 minutes. Record this clip. We have been relatively busy. I don't act no, the last video was the cart, and the cart doesn't even exist anymore. There'll be an update on that thing soon. But yeah, we've been relatively busy. Ah, fuck it. Someone's sleeping. I slept recently. And by that I mean, we built the TARDIS, and it's for some reason there's no beacon be. Ah, there it is. And it's well, the exterior is done. The interior of the TARDIS is a different story because we still have a lot to do, but. Yeah. Has anyone been digging in here? No one's been helping me out in here. Well, shit. But yeah, the interior of the TARDIS, that's gonna be a whole thing in itself. We're not focusing on that because it's Joseph's thing. So, this is the big part. Bam. Not that, but this. Yeah. This all used to be hilly and terrible land. And now it's roads for me to start putting buildings in and putting farms inside of buildings and such. And don't worry, the leg has stayed, the oh great leg. And I stated that it will be kept. This will be a park or something, but. Yeah, over here I'm starting to get the town hall together, which finally, after so many years of wanting to do this, I am finally getting to do a fully fledged Back to the Future town hall. I've wanted to do it for the longest time, and I'm here. I get to do it, and this will have a full interior, hopefully. Because the ones that I've built in the past never had full interior. They had a courtroom, that was about it. But yeah, it's very bare bones at the moment still, because I'm in the middle of building it still. But yeah, it is in good shape so far. Well, yeah, we are in really good shape, honestly. There's been a lot that we've been doing just off camera, and it's honestly so much like just grindy shit that I can't show it. So there's nothing really interesting. To it. But yeah, here's where we're gonna put a creeper farm. We're gonna put a secondary iron farm in here. The winking creeper will go here. It's gotta stay left side of the road, like usual. And yeah, though there's still so much to do, but I would definitely say that we are ahead of schedule for this, 'cause we're doing a lot better than we were on the last server. We're not having too big of resource issues, though the TARDIS is a pretty major setback down inside of it. I'll show that after the restart. One of the things that we've managed to obtain is Ray no longer needs his base here, so we now have a secondary oh boy. We now have a secondary skeleton spawner, and we have our own iron farm. He said that we're free to use these. Of course, I'm not taking any of Ray's stuff yet, because, well, I don't know what he's gonna need. He's busy with other things. Oh, he didn't remove chests. Well, still, I'm not gonna take stuff from Ray if he. Yeah, like right there's a fucking fortune pick sitting there. I don't want to go taking anything without him. Yeah, there's stuff that Ray wants here, probably, so I'm gonna let him. I'm gonna let him take care of, the stuff when he can get it out of here. But for now, this is weird. For now, this is pretty bare bones. So. And we're probably not looking to to use this land anytime soon. The only thing that we might be. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, that might be a raid farm. Okay, now that we're back. But yeah, this is going to be a raid farm down the line. I guess Ray had plans to maybe put something here. I don't know if someone's claimed this or not. We're gonna have to. Not, there should be a sign. In which case, I'm gonna try to ignore these guys. Yeah, I don't know if someone actually wants this, but in reality, Teague and I'll take these. Thank you. I'll take these now. But yeah, if Ray and Teague, or not Ray, if Teague and Jay ever want share a raid farm or something there, more than or more than sure that we could probably work something out. So yeah, other things that have happened, other things that have happened. Copper farm is not really anything significant to really show off, but we have a copper farm underground now. Thankfully, it runs along the stretch of a river, actually. So apparently, that's good. That's all up to my cousin, honestly, with how he's building that. But Late Bird, on the other hand, it's moved. Pretty sure I haven't shown it in a video, but Le Bird is no longer where it used to be, and it's a bit bigger and better and more finished than it ever has been. So between now and then, yes, the cart is gone. We'll get into that situation in a different video, so don't worry about that one. But Le Bird is now in prime real estate. I think Lay Bird is in a pretty good spot, honestly. So yeah, but we're selling all the normal things as per usual. Of course, we did a little Valentine's Day special. We still have some stuff left over from that, but yeah, selling all the normal stuff as usual. No sales today, as far as I'd like to assume. No, probably not. But yeah, it's more finished than ever. Up here, we're gonna sell books, and I'm slowly working on getting a library together for that, but where Laybird used to be, we kinda did something pretty stupid, and we did it off camera. So we probably only legitimately moved the building 100 blocks forward, but we decided to leave the foundation of Laybird. Is a giant spruce foundation. And Joseph also went and filled in everything that was podzol too, so yeah, that's what that is now. Honestly, while I'm over here. So things are probably gonna look a little weird to you right now because I ain't running Optifine and Optifabric is not updated to 118.2 yet, so yeah. But to give you an update on everything that I've been doing here, because last I recorded it, I know I was. I don't have a zoom button. I was working on this, and I don't look. This don't look as good without Optifine, unfortunately, but. Yeah. I don't think I technically need fabric at the moment. I don't have anything big going on. I might just kind of say screw it and just go with Optifine for a little bit and kind of go old school, which is kind of how I roll still anyways, but yeah, I have been very busy getting stuff together because I kind of gave myself a bit of a deadline here for getting Main Street done here. Again, of course. where history's repeating itself as per usual. But yeah, we have until April 20th to get this whole street done, including my pier idea that I want to do. So we have a significant amount of work to do, and I'm starting on it slowly here. Of course, nothing is like really set in stone with any of it yet, too. So there's that to worry about. But the town hall is pretty much at where it's gonna be for the time being. And it's in a pretty good place, honestly. It's pretty much ready to get an interior put into it. Of course, if there's anybody who watches this in the Nebula server and you want to put an interior inside of this building for me, just let me know, because I would be more than willing to have someone do it instead of me doing it, because I have to start putting up other buildings and planning stuff out. As you can see, I'm already starting to work on one of the buildings, which is going to have a creeper farm inside of it, so it's not going to really be a functional building, but it's going to, it's going to house this inside of it, which is going to be a good thing. Be amazed that I'm doing this either way. But yeah, I'm still going to place all the trapdoors and everything. I don't know how efficient of a farm it's going to be, because I've never really done one before. Also, this happened. I don't remember if I showed it or not, but there's TARDIS. Say hi to the TARDIS. And we also have this now, which is a tree farm. So, we're slowly getting automated, but I think the biggest update is going to be out at a new area of ours. I just realized I'm going to be completely fucking lost without my waypoints. Oh boy. Well, yeah, maybe waiting for Op the Fabric to update is probably the better idea at the moment. I can't really disclose what or why I gave myself this deadline, because none of it is really set in stone yet. This is just stuff that we talked about the other night, and I'm trying to do the responsible thing for myself here and cover my ass early so that I don't have to mad rush in the end. But the other thing that we now have going for us is, if I can get there, come on. Can't wait until we have another hub so I can just make a connection to this. But we now have an area that we can put a bunch of really big and bulky farms out at. Because, of course, I can't really fit a farm inside of every building in the city. Some of them need to have purpose inside of them. So, oh, we also have this lush cave. We'll get into that in another video down the line here. But once we go up this ladder, basically claimed a section of ocean near the border. So, A, we can put up a guardian farm. There's a temple nearby this place, and fingers crossed that we add the guardian drop for Sponge. I fingers crossed for that. But yeah. There you go. No zoom again. And then I also built this. This is a raid farm. And be amazed. This farm kicked my ass, but it works. We have a bunch of emeralds. And that's kind of the pure purpose of this place, is to just make our emerald collection easier. So, yeah. But yeah, this is built now, and it sorts, pretty much everything that I would want to keep from this place. Minus, like, all this stuff, of course. I want to keep the totems and stuff, because we're stocking those at LeBird now. But... yeah. Raid farm. It's fun. I'm going to have to come and clean this out one of these days, though. But I'm not worried about a raid farm at the moment, because... well, I have shit that I need to build, and I need to test build a lot of stuff. I'm actually at the point that where I think I'm going to pawn off the PNPD building to someone else and just tell them, hey, listen, if you can toss this up in a day, fine by fucking me. So. Yeah. So I would like to say that the next 6 weeks will be jam-packed with videos. But I do not think so. That it's going to be a mad dash for me to get some of this stuff done. And it feels like September again when I was prepping for Forsaken Riders stuff daily for fucking 2 months. So, yeah. With how slow I get shit done in this game, and because I don't have many farms to my name, it's going to take some time. But, okay, if I remember correctly, the last clip that I've done was showing off the progress of the town hall, and this isn't really progressed anywhere, because so much has happened. I thought I'd be able to do a better job of keeping track of this stuff, but I have not. So, this is going to serve as a purpose to just kind of keep everything updated and keep everything kind of on track here, because, yeah, a lot's going on, and a lot kind of happened at once. We already started to cover our asses for the Nebula anniversary that's coming up. And that is 3 weeks away as of when I'm recording this. And my goal is to basically make Main Street look all nice and pretty, which I think we're doing a pretty good job of so far. I had Dahl come in and build the PNPD for me, thankfully. Fen is working on an aquarium for me, which is great. Oh, he even came in here and worked on it more. Sweet. I wonder if he's missing shit still. I'll have to ask him. But, yeah. I came in here and basically, and asked Fen if he could, if he wants to, he can do an aquarium for me. And he knocked it out of the park with this building. I'm excited to see what he does with it. So, yeah. The Winking Creeper's, like, 80% done, I'd like to say, but I did, I had Lena redo the interior for me. These are gonna get taken down. I'm gonna let Sean put up his own banners, but, yeah, Lena came in and basically redid the entire first floor interior for me, because I don't have a bunch of the knickknacks that I would have had from, the old server, to where it was kind of more like a home restaurant kind of a thing. Like, if you've ever been one of those, like, highway rest stop kind of family diners where they have all, like, the old signs and shit on the wall, that was the original goal with the interior, but I don't have a lot of that right now, so I asked Lena to come in and give us the new interior, and, yeah, she drove me absolutely crazy with the amount of shit she uses for interiors, honestly. So, yeah. This is finally going to become a thing, if anybody remembers. I'm finally going to put storage up here, but that's not needed for the anniversary. But upstairs is pretty bleak right now. Sean's going to live up on the second floor, on the third floor again. And I think I know what I'm going to do with the second floor. I think this is going to become like a small inn. Because in the prototype version of this building, I have a sign that goes out on the front. So I think We're gonna put an inn on the second floor. I think that might be a little fun idea. And it gives Sean more to control. He can go and bother the guests with whatever he wants to do. But yeah, a lot of the same shit just kind of crossed over from the old building, with the fire escape and everything like that. The billboard, it's good that it kind of lined up like that. But yeah. Bowling alley, this is something I've had designed for a while, and this is pretty much like 99% done. I just need to get some heads together, but I'm not worried about doing that right now. This place is, it's done. It's checked off my list. So the only building left that I need to design is an arcade. And I don't know how I'm gonna do that yet, but that's next. I gotta build the casing for this terrible monstrosity of what was gonna be a creeper farm, but it don't work that good. I'm gonna keep it because that's just what's been gathered while I've been working in the area, but yeah, it don't work that good. PMPD's gonna need a whole video itself for what I need to do inside of there. But this building here, we can actually go into the creative server really quick, show it off. This is what we need for the anniversary. If people remember, we did a Christmas stream in 2020, and I built a theater for it, and me and Joseph wanted to basically make a really special theater this time around for the city. Or have it be included in the city, because it was kind of weird that we had a theater in the middle of nowhere. But yeah, this one's of course named that we're gonna continue the trend of naming it after my dead cats. So since Spasmo passed away, this is now the Spasmo Memorial Theater. But yeah, I cut a lot of corners in this place because I needed to get it done, and I need to get started building it so we can have it done in time. But there's gonna be like gift shops and like a food stand, a ticket booth. But really, all we need is just the interior here for the stage and everything. So there's a way to get up onto like the upper balcony, which I painfully tried to make sure that from almost every seat, you can pretty much see the stage standing. I know we have the sit command. The sit command makes it a little difficult, but that's not a vanilla feature. But yeah, if you sit here and crouch, you can see the podium from the upper balcony. So that was a big thing that I wanted to do this time because it was an issue we ran into with the last theater. But yeah, of course, everything down here. We got plenty of seating. It's a big room this time. It's like well lit. This is one of my more proud things that I've done here. They kind of look like curtains. But yeah, like there's obviously the whole backstage is missing. This is kind of just like slapped together so we could use it for any special effects, of course. Yeah. And there's supposed to be a lot of stuff, because especially way up here, I made sure to also include basically like a box room or like a film room pretty much, where you'd be able to come and control the lights. I'm just gonna skip doing that for now, because it's just too much work. And obviously, as you can see, like this building's really here for one purpose. It's not really here to it's not really here to exist as like a building that can like have apartments above it or anything like that, which I think is like the real life counterpart of this building. I'll explain that in a second, but yeah, this place is really kind of just slapped together at the moment, and I'm hoping in survival when it's built and Once we get past the anniversary, we can I can at least sit down and better make the build. Like, it doesn't even have a completed roof for the schematic, so it I fell really behind on this building. I wanted to have it at least started like at least a week ago, but I ended up getting sick, so it didn't really help me. But we're now here. The building is like maybe like 85%, and that's good enough to get the event out of the way that we want to do at the anniversary, so yeah. Now I just gotta build it, and I'm not excited to because this is a really fucking big building, and as you can see on the creative server, yeah, it has a presence. Especially the one part about it that I love, you can see the theater sign. That makes me really, really happy that I did it that way. It adds more color to the streets, so yeah. We're doing pretty good with this main street already. I guess I'm getting good at doing this city thing, because I've basically did all of what I wanted to do at Main Street and on the old world, but within like a month. Oh boy, the thing's not happy rendering. So you can see all the holes in the wall and everything that that are left over. But yeah, this is this is pretty much the goal right now. I mean, of course, if I have time, I'm gonna throw this building up. If not, it's just gonna be a really terribly made facade with like a dumpster blocking the alleyway or something. And the big thing that I want to do is basically get the tunnel figured out, because now we can have custom shaped portals. So, tunnel that goes through here. And it can connect up with this area, so the areas can kind of be connected. If I can get all of that done for the anniversary, I'll be sitting pretty for a lot of other stuff too. And it's doable. I got about 3 weeks from recording this, so yeah. Have I gone insane yet? Yes, this place has driven me crazy. I want to go do other things, but I have things that I need to. I have this to do before I can go and do those other things, so this is kind of important to get done. So, yeah. But here's the video that was recorded over the course of like 3 months at this point now, because I've just been so bad about getting it edited. But yeah, oh, that's interesting. We're just gonna go and turn that. Oh, fuck, I didn't mean to remove it. Well, shit. Oh, also, thank you, Monty, for dropping off all these resources. You've been so great. We don't need that, but you know what? It's there. Yeah, Monty's been absolutely great about helping me out with getting materials together. I need to do that myself and also just organize my life on the server because it's just a mess right now. So, right, I'm off to go and grind more resources. But yeah, stay tuned because we got some really cool shit coming up here. And yeah, Nebula Anniversary's coming up, so stay tuned for the live stream announcements for that, because I'm doing something the day before I've pretty much planned now, and I'm gonna be doing something the day after, obviously, with the anniversary, so it's gonna kind of be like a weekend event type of thing. So yeah, get ready, people. We got some fun stuff coming. Hopefully you have enjoyed though, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.